Thank you so much. I'm delighted to be with you digitally. Let me start by addressing certain amongst the remarks that you just raised vis-a-vis COVID-19 acting as a digital accelerator. This is indeed the case. I mean, in our case, we had a very comprehensive strategy which was announced just after the election that took place in 2019 and this government coming into office. The strategy of the Prime Minister, Kyriakos Mitsotakis, was the creation effectively of a new organization which would be responsible for the horizontal implementation of this strategy across the state, the Ministry of Digital Governance. We had announced that we would pursue a strategy, a document which would codify the strategy, also with an application plan with the specific projects which we would be deploying in the next years, which we call the Digital Transformation Bible. And more or less, what we had designed is exactly what we decided to pursue after COVID-19 hit. And in reality, we took an already existing strategy, that of simplifying and digitizing processes of the state, make the KPI effectively involve the administrative burdens, making the lives of citizens and corporations easier in their interaction with the Greek state, along with addressing and making better infrastructure and investing in better infrastructure in Greece in many areas. So we took the strategy and we, in a sense, instrumentalized it also as a tool to battle the virus, because we knew that as we're eliminating interactions, we're also helping in this process. In this regard, it's actually, I think, quite timely that the beginning of the first lockdown of the pandemic last year, we launched gov.gr, which is the government platform, the single government portal, very much inspired by the UK experience, actually, by gov.uk. It started with 501 services in March 2020. Now we have almost reached 1,200 services, a bit more than a year later. And this manifests, I would say, both the speed and the commitment of this team to deliver better digital services. In reality, what we have done, and Mr. Christopoulos in the panel with you, the General Secretary of Digital Governance, is entrusted with the simplification along with the digitization process, is to take all life events of citizens and corporations, though they can be codified in a continuum of 300 to 1,000, depending on whether you focus on the most frequent or a bit less frequent services. From the birth of a child to the passing of a loved one, in that continuum, you have a full spectrum of events. And we tried, using simple digital technologies, but also regulatory and legal changes, to simplify and digitize at the same time. And this, in reality, is manifested, as I mentioned, by the amount of services, by the volume of services provided by gov.gr, which is the key reform process. It's the new way in which we try to reconstruct the Greek state vis-a-vis its interaction with the citizens. And we also view it as a trust accelerator, because in reality, the state in this manner, with this new facet that it has, this new face that it has, better serves citizens, especially in a very challenging period, that of the pandemic. The numbers speak for themselves. If you look at the volume of electronic transactions overall, both by authentication of citizens or by interoperability, and you add those two numbers up, in 2018, we had 8.8 million digital transactions overall. Those are 8.8 million visits not made in 2018. And in 2020, we had 94 million. So this is a times 11 leap in 2 years. It's a function of demand, obviously. This is the role of COVID. But I would say that it's primarily a function of the supply of new services, because we developed and created more and more and more services. Some examples involve us moving forward in accordance with the Pareto rule. 20% of one thing can be 80% of another thing. So in reality, we knew that 20% of services are 80% of the traffic. So we started by the most frequently used ones in our digitization process. Power of Attorney is such an example. Our e-prescription system is another. And we will keep on delivering. Our strategy is delivery of services. Every week, new services are being added in that portal, I would say almost every day. Now, our commitment, of course, also involves us focusing on applications. In reality, gov.gr is also offered as an app on mobile phones, but we will keep on adding new services. Before The month is out. We will release our e-health application, where we will start building electronic patient records. We already have some of the data digitized. We used it a lot during the vaccination process during COVID-19. So the data of our e-prescription system, which we have in place for some years, will now be offered to citizens. Citizens will obtain access to their data, effectively, which today they don't have, through an application layer and through a portal. And for us, this is quite significant. The value of digital obviously was manifested also by the vaccination process itself. It was a service design exercise, effectively. And I would say that this is the core of the focus of this ministry, service design. We're using digital in order to design better services, but we're also using a physical layer as well, because we have people without digital skills or without comprehensive digital skills. And if you look at our vaccination system, which I would claim is one of the best, certainly in the European Union, but perhaps also in the world, it's a multi-channel approach, a digital platform, which very much looks like an airline ticket, airline booking platform, an e-prescription system in parallel with that, where those already enrolled, more than 2 million Greeks, around 2.3 million Greeks, received proposed vaccination appointments by us, and all they had to do was confirm or deny, and physical channels, not call centers like in other places, which they didn't work, but making use of the citizen service centers and primarily of the pharmacy stores in Greece, where citizens who don't have digital skills, who couldn't use the platforms, could just go show up and book their appointments there. What we claim is that this vaccination process, it's about the vaccine, but it's not only about the vaccine, it's a message. It's a message about how one can design better services, digital A to Z, and deliver better services to citizens overall. And this is the goal of this government and the goal of this ministry. Of course, digital is not only about services, about public, about the state and public sector services. It's about many other things as well. There was a study recently published by Deloitte, overall for member states of the EU. And in reality, in the assessment of Greece, what was quite vivid in this study was the fact that if you look at the various the various dimensions of digital, public services, telecommunications, skills, and the penetration of digital in the private sector, Greece managed to move the needle significantly vis-a-vis what I just described, public sector digital services. Telecommunication will play, we need a little bit more time because it involves procurement and infrastructural decisions that are being made right now or in the last 2 years. But there I would claim that as well, vis-a-vis our design of the 5G auction process, we also innovated. We managed to design not only a business-friendly 5G auction, but a very innovative 5G auction, one of the most innovative in the world, where 25% of the auction proceeds are endowing a venture capital fund, which will invest in the 5G ecosystem in Greece. I understand that this is considered throughout the EU as a case study and as a policy design mechanism to be emulated by other member states. I understand that France recently announced that they are also focusing on the vertical implications of 5G in all the vertical sectors of the economy, and they are trying to make similar investment decisions like the ones we did. And obviously the RRF, in conclusion, the overall financial opportunities that we will have to invest in digital and overall in the restructuring of the Greek economic model is a significant opportunity. It's a Marshall Plan for our times. Our digital strategy, which would have been, I would say, less aggressive, I would be less optimistic with the financial capabilities that we had in 2019. Back then, when we were developing the digital Bible, we had to make very hard choices vis-a-vis the projects that we would finance, that we would select to invest at. Now this this opportunity of the RRF is allowing us to finance 100% of our strategy, not only the outstanding issues of the past, not only what we still need to resolve vis-a-vis the third industrial revolution, digitization per se, but in reality also a full spectrum of projects apart from what I just mentioned, which involve building bridges with the future, the fourth industrial revolution, in a sense, all the things which would allow us to claim that very quickly Greece will be able to perform a full leapfrogging act in the digital sphere. I firmly believe that we're fully capable to do so. We have very talented engineers, very talented people who work in the digital sectors of the Greek economy. And as this strategy manifests itself, which it has during this very challenging period, it will become more vivid, more visible that we're able to perform this leap. Thank you so much.